Hi, my name is Christy Blasier, and I am here to guide you through the math portion of the Next-Generation ACCUPLACER placement test. I will explain the test and offer some strategies so you can be ready to do your best. The motivational speaker, Zig Ziglar, offers some good advice saying, "You don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great." So with that in mind, let's get started. As a new student at Lakeland, you need to be placed into a math course before you're able to register for classes. If you've taken the ACT, SAT, or if you submit a transcript from another school showing qualifying college-level math credit, you may be able to be placed in a math course without taking the ACCUPLACER math placement test. See the information on the screen for more details. So now, let's talk about the test itself. Here are a few details to keep in mind. There is no time limit. Take as much time as you need. I suggest making sure to give yourself an hour to an hour and a half in your schedule, but many students finish faster than that. There are 20 multiple choice questions for each test you see. Some students are asked to take a second 20 question test. This isn't a bad sign. Instead, it's to be sure they are placed in the correct class. We want to be sure you're in a class that both challenges you and also gives you the best chance to be successful. You cannot return to questions to change answers. The only calculators you may use are the ones that are embedded into the test. The calculator option will automatically appear for questions in which you are permitted to use one. There are three types of tests: arithmetic, quantitative reasoning, algebra, and statistics, and advanced algebra and functions. Everyone starts with the quantitative reasoning, algebra, and statistics portion of the test. The nice thing about the math placement test is that it's computer adaptive. It adjusts according to your ability. So, as you get more problems correct, the test will adjust to harder problems. And if you start getting problems incorrect, the test will adjust to easier problems. Remember, we are trying to get you in the right course to be successful. It is possible you will have to complete more than one of these tests. The arithmetic test covers topics such as whole number operations, decimal operations, number comparisons and equivalents, fraction operations, and percentages. You will see about four questions on each topic. The topics that are covered on the quantitative reasoning, algebra, and statistics test are rational numbers, exponents, linear equations, probability and sets, geometry concepts, ratio and proportion relationships, algebraic expressions, linear applications and graphs, and descriptive statistics. You will see between 1 to 4 questions for each of these topics. Lastly, the topics that appear on the advanced algebra and functions tests are linear equations, factoring, functions, polynomial equations, trigonometry, linear applications and graphs, quadratics, radical and rational equations, geometry concepts, and exponential and logarithmic equations. Each topic will range between 1 and 4 questions. Now that you know what's on the test, let's talk about some strategies for doing well. First, and maybe most important, be sure to read each question carefully and completely. Don't start answering the question before you have read it all and know what information is given and what the test is asking for. When you read through the questions, be sure to look out for words such as not, except, least, false, only, always, never, most. These words will change which answer you should pick. When solving the problem, use the paper and pencil and draw pictures as needed. Use the embedded calculator if it's available on the question. A strategy I would recommend for multiple choice questions is to eliminate answers and make an educated guess when you don't know the answer. First, eliminate answers you know are wrong. Then, zero in on which answer you think is right out of the ones that remain. Another strategy I recommend that is specific to math depends on the form your answers are given in. If the answer choices are numbers, work backwards. Plug each answer choice into the problem to see which works. If the answer choices have variables in them, Then pick a random number to represent the variable. Plug that number into both the problem and the answer choices to see which one answers the question. For this last option, we generally avoid choosing 0 or 1 as our random number, as these sometimes don't work in the problem. But the best strategy is to take the test seriously. The better your score, the higher math course you place in, and the faster you can complete your degree, allowing you to make the best use of your time and financial resources. The whole reason you have to take the placement test is to be sure your first math class is a good fit for you. On the screen is information showing which course your score places you in. In order to start in a college-level math course, meaning you'll receive credit toward your degree or certificate, you need a score of 263 or above on the Quantitative Reasoning or Advanced Algebra test. Your scores are available immediately after you've completed the test. You should then make an appointment with a Lakeland counselor to help you schedule your classes for your first semester. If you want to get even more information about what to expect on the placement test, there are many online free resources available. A few I recommend are the Next-Generation ACCUPLACER study app, the printable sample tests, Longsdale Publishing, and Khan Academy. You can find links to these resources on Lakeland's placement test webpage. Lakeland also offers additional help and practice to help you be ready for the placement test. I've made another video showing a few sample problems and talking you through the strategies I mentioned earlier in this video. You can find this on Lakeland's placement test webpage. Also, you can call or stop in to the Learning Center. We have a math placement navigator that can help make sure you're ready to do your best before the placement test. We want you to be successful, and we're here to help. Good luck!